my dear yogis, how are you doing? We finally, we are finishing 2020. Let's do our last practice of the year. The next one is going to be already in January. So I hope you enjoy. You have been enjoying all those videos on my channel. Please subscribe to support the channel. And if you want to do any donation, you will find the PayPal link. And if you are in Switzerland, I finally got the tweet. Well, we're going to start today in this position. But, you know, if you have a very big discomfort or pain in your knees, you modify or you use a cushion here behind your knees. Maybe that helps. And also, we are not going to stay too long here. So you can take a little bit more distance between your knees. And then just take a moment to relax your shoulders back, rotate your shoulders a few times. Start breathing consciously through your nose and connecting to your body through your breath flow. Breathe in, bring your shoulders up. Breathing down, bring your shoulders downwards. Breathing out. Breathing out, you go down with the shoulders, elongating your neck. Breathing in, you bring your shoulders towards your ears just a few times. And finally, relax your shoulders down, your arms, your hands on your legs, on your knees. Relax your belly muscles and allow your breath to flow deep down to your belly. And to move the navel out as you're breathing in. And as you're breathing out, the navel moves in towards your spine. Keep your neck long. You can turn your head to the left and to the right a few times. And continue to deepen your breath, to elongate your breath. And you can move your head, chin up, chin down. If you can coordinate with your breath, that movement, gentle movement. Breathe in, head back, breathe out, head forward. And when you rotate your head, you can also coordinate with the breath. Breathe in to the left, breathe out to the right. And you can also go for a big circle. Head down, breathing out. Head back, breathing in. Left and right. Continue to deepen the breath, elongate the breath, and we start then leaning forward. We want to keep our hips back there, the sitting bones towards the heels. And we stretch the arms forward, reach forward with the fingertips, or if you prefer with your palms, but still keep your arms straight and allow your chest to go down and the forehead. And now feel your breath on your back, behind your navel, next to the spine, and behind the heart, between the shoulder blades. Feel that space as you're breathing in. There is that expansion. As you're breathing out, just releasing the tension you don't need, allowing the chest to go down, stretching both sides of your trunk. And also the lower back area, opening more space there, creating room. Maybe you touch your chin down to the floor. You don't have to force anything, remember. Now spread your fingers, press your palms down to the floor, and with the next inhalation, you start coming up and distribute your weight on your knees, on your hands, adjust the position, round your spine, keep your elbows straight. Breathe out. Swing a little bit back and forth. And breathe in, arch the other way around, look forward. Breathe out, look towards the navel. And continue on your own rhythm. Breathing in, expanding, breathing out, contracting. So the navel moves in, chin in. At the same time, you swing a little bit back and forth. Feels good for the back muscles. One more time. And of course, you can always use a gentle ujjayi breath. Now, next time you're breathing in, you come slightly forward with your weight. And keeping your knees right above, keeping your hips right above your knees, you start stretching again your arms forward, palms or fingertips, and you go down with the chest and with the forehead, or with the forehead. Well, now, you can also try to bend your elbows here, touch your arms down, and bring your palms together, and you arch a little bit more, you open a little bit more your chest here, you feel your triceps elongating the area of your armpit. Take a few breaths here. Now also here you feel it, you engaging the muscles right below your navel. You're engaging Mula Bandha, Uddiyana Bandha. And breathe out, slowly coming back. Place your hands on the floor and walk with your hands underneath your shoulders, more or less. So you take the space you need here. Rotate your shoulders back, breathe in, arch forward. Curl your toes under, breathe out, and push slowly to downward facing dog. Relax your head, then looking towards your feet, you can start moving your legs, walking movement, bend one leg, extend the other one, lift one heel, go down with the other one. Keep your breath flowing. Flowing regular through your nose. You can also come up with both heels, breathing in, breathing out, pushing the heels down, pulling your hips up and back a few times. Now, lift your heels, breathe in, and slowly bend your knees, but don't touch the floor. Feeling the core muscles. Now look forward, breathe in, extend your legs, breathe out, bend your knees. Breathe in, expand a few times only. Breathe out, bend. Breathe in, expand. Breathe out, bend. Two more. One. Breathe in, extend. Breathe out. Now touch the knees down. Keep the belly strong. Bend your elbows in. Lower the chest and chin. Point your toes. Drop your hips. Roll your shoulders back. Breathe in. Open your chest in cobra. Always with elbows. Not like this, extended, bend, close to the trunk. Breathe out, lower the body, lift your feet off the floor, extend your arms forward, and stretch, arms forward, hands forward, feet back, pointing the toes, breathe in. Breathe out, move then your elbows close to your body, hands to the floor, up to cobra again, exhale on the knees, round your spine. Breathe in, open the chest, curl your toes under, breathe out, stretch. Now let's take five breath, stable in the pose. Also here we're feeling we have Mula Bandha, Uddiyana Bandha engaged. And we keep the left foot down and we go up then. With the next inhalation, be careful there where you are. We go up with the right leg. Move a little bit your foot, your ankle. Rotate. Rotate in and out. A few times, then bend your knee and rotate. Doing circles from the hip joint a few times, drawing circles with the knee. In and out. Breathing. Breathe in, leg up. Breathe out. Come on the tip of your toes. Knee to the chest and the foot towards your right hand. Lunge position on the fingertips, or maybe like this. Extend your back leg. Keep your five toes pressing there. Now pull the right hip back. Exhale. Maybe pointing the toes up from the front foot. Off the front foot. Otherwise, keep the toes down. Now breathe in. Bend the front knee. Elongate. Breathe out. Extend. Dropping the head. One more time. Breathe in, bend, breathe out, extend, Mula Bandha, Uddiyana Bandha, one more, breathe in, stay, breathe out, rotate right side, you have your right leg in front, right side, take another breath, keep the back leg straight. Breathe out, fingertips to the floor. If you want, go for one more. Extension here of the front leg. Breathe in, bending the front knee. Breathe out. Now go again with your right arm back and place your right palm on the sacrum. We rotate the shoulder and we go down with the left knee. Support on your left hand. Allow the hips to go down. Allow the front knee to go a little bit to the side to make space. And rotate. And you're resting here. Breathing. You're feeling that nice stretch also on the left side of the hip in front. The hip flexor. Ah, let me take another breath. Let go with the exhalation. And coming forward, place your hands inside of the foot. You find the space, toes back there. Extend your back leg. Walk back to downward facing. Just feel it for a moment. Left and right side. Something has changed, even the temperature. Stay there for another breath. And we're going up with the left leg. Left leg up, left foot. And we start rotating a few times. Ankle moving. And we bend the left knee and we do some circles, growing circles. In and out a few times. Left hip joint. Breathe in. Leg up, breathe out, come up on your toes, pull the navel in, knee forward, left foot towards your left hand. And come here with the left hand next to the foot, fingertips. Extend your back leg, breathe in, elongate, lunge. Breathe out. Pull the left hip back and extend also your front leg. Drop your head. And again, bend the front knee, keep the back leg straight. Inhale, elongate. Exhale. Extend. Head down. One more time. Inhale. Exhale. Next time, inhale, bend the front knee, keep your right hand down, exhale. Inhale up, left side. Stay for another breath. Exhale. Back here. And if you want, go for another stretch of the front leg. Back heel is always up there. Now breathe in, bending the front knee. And go back with your left arm again. Rotate your shoulder, place your left palm on your sacrum. Breathe out, right knee down. Support on your right hand. And allow the knee to open a little bit to the side, to fall a little bit to the side. And the edge of the foot is on the floor. And we rotate a little bit more. Breathe. Let go with the exhalation. Let go down to the earth. Let go of the tension. Feel that nice stretch now on the right side in front. Right hip flexor, abdominal, quadriceps. And I know you also Feeling your left hip. You're feeling everything, the whole body in the pose. Now we're coming forward. Place the hands inside of the foot. Find the space. Tuck your toes. Back foot. Lift. Step back to downward facing and just feel it. Breathe. Deep inhalation, long exhalation. We found a little bit more space everywhere. One more deep breath. Exhale, inhale, come up on your toes. Walk, step forward, still keeping your feet hip apart. And fall forward in Uttanasana, grabbing your elbows or your forearms, opposite hand. Relax your head, your trunk, your shoulders. Relax your neck, your face. Let's stay. Two more breaths. Long and deep breath. Just allowing the trunk to sink with the exhalation. You know you can always bend your knees a little bit, that's no problem. To be able to bend forward and relax the back. Exhale. Next time, we start bending the knees. Release the position of your arms and place your hands on your knees and come up slowly, arch your spine, extend your elbows, inhale, look forward, exhale, arch backwards, inhale, arch forward, exhale, arch back, hold your breath outside, pull the navel in and up. Suck the belly in, Uddiyana Bandha, no air in your lungs, just a few seconds. Then release the contraction and you can breathe in. Breathe out, one more time. Hold your breath outside. Pull the navel in and up. Deep contraction and release and breathe in. Last one, breathe out, hold the breath outside, pull the navel in and up, just a few seconds, and you release the contraction to breathe in again. Breathe out, push the feet down to the floor, bring your hands to your waist, and legs straight, we go in a gentle back bend. Push your hips slightly forward, ground your feet, lift the sternum, lift your chin, breathe up to the top of your chest, to the throat. One more. Breathe in the middle of the chest. Breathe in, breathe out, and just start bending your knees, sitting on the chair, touch your knees, arms straight, the trunk elongating, and stay. Just stay, a few breaths in the chair pose. Exhale. Now, transfer your weight. Let's say you transfer your weight to your right foot now, and you come up with your left knee, and pull everything up towards the ceiling. Now, flex your foot, Bring your hands to your waist. Bring your left leg back there and you go down a little bit with your trunk. Try not to point the toes. That control of the hip rotating in and out. It's better, easier if you keep your toes pointing down. Take another breath. Exhale, bend your front knee. Step back with your left foot and take a good distance. Feet in the same line. Extend your front leg and your arms. Take your time. Breathe in. Move your trunk forward towards your front leg. Breathe out. Touch very gently. Rotate, bringing everything in the same line for triangle. And here we're going back with the left elbow, left arm, left shoulder rotating back. And the left hand is reaching towards the right hip. And we rotate a little bit more. Feet really firm. Breathe in. Breathe out, bend your front knee, press the right arm against your leg to keep the knee pointing forward. Keep the back leg straight, rotate a little bit more. Breathe. Exhale, rotating forward. Now turn your back foot, turn your back leg. Let's give one of those stretches. Front leg, exhale. Inhale, bend the front knee, elongate your trunk, pull your arms forward, keep the navel, pull it in. Exhale, transition. Forward, step, feet parallel, take a deep breath, up with your arms, stretch, breathe out, bring your hands to your waist, firm your feet, gently back bend, open the chest, look up without forcing your head back, keep space in the back of your neck, no pain. Breathe out, look forward, bend your knees, sit, chair pose, stay. Stay one more breath. Stay one more breath. And exhale, press through your left foot, transferring the weight to the left foot. Come up with your right knee, growing up towards the ceiling. Your eyes must be really calmly looking towards one point, that helps. Flex your foot, bring your hands to your waist, lean forward, and bring your right leg back. Third warrior. Only as a transition, one breath. Bend your front knee, exhale, place the right foot, take the distance you need. Extend both legs and your arms. Breathe. Make sure the position of the back foot is the right way. And that you don't have pain. Elongate left side forward towards your left leg. Breathe in. Breathe out. Touch gently. Rotating up. Bend your right elbow behind your back. And send your right shoulder back while your right hand is reaching towards your left hip. At the same time, you're rotating, you're also elongating. You rotate with space. Take another breath. Exhale, start bending the front knee. And we go here like we did on the other side. You can also support the hand on the floor. Just don't go down with your weight. Use your left arm to press against your left leg and rotate a little bit more. Don't bend your back knee. Keep pressing the edge of the back foot down to the floor. One more breath. Exhale. Rotate forward. Hands to the floor. Rotate your back foot. Push all your toes back there and let's stretch the front leg. Exhale. Maybe one breath here. Bend the front knee. Keep the back leg straight. Pull the navel in. Inhale. Exhale, stay. Transition. Bring your foot forward. Feet parallel. Growing up. Breathe in. Stretch. Breathe out. One more time we go here. Not doing that many cobras, so we're doing this. Back bend and standing. Press the feet down. You go one more time. Don't exaggerate. Don't force. Breathe up to the top of your chest. And then as you're breathing out, falling forward with the hands, the fingers interlaced behind you. Drop your head, relax your neck and your face. 5 breaths. Feeling what is going on with the shoulders, the chest. With the exhalation, you let go downwards. With the next exhalation, we're going to bend the knees, sink the hips, chest, head, hands on the floor. Step into plank pose. Now we go through a full vinyasa movement. Let's go there. Directly down or knees, chest, chin, like we did before. Exhale. Point your toes, inhale. How is your cobra? Exhale on your knees. You stay. Round your spine. Elbows straight. Head totally relaxed. And then we do the circles, left and right. Circle. Feel the breath on your back. Swing back and forth. Allowing the hips to go down a little bit more, so like we have like the beginning of the class. Stretch, relax, stretch the arms forward, relax the forehead down, just feel the breath. Both sides of your trunk under your arms. Behind your navel, lower back area. And then come forward. Bring your legs forward. place the feet parallel for that shoulder bridge. Oh, we cannot miss that one. And prepare to go up with the hips. Feet, remember feet, ankle, knee, not too far in front, the feet. Otherwise, the hips cannot go down, up. Not too far, not too close to the buttock muscles, otherwise you cannot go up. You will find your way. And when you're ready, come up with your hips. Jalandhara Bandha, chin lock, chin in. The back of the neck is elongated. We come up with the hips, with the belly, with the chest towards the chin. Five long, deep breaths. Mula Bandhu Dhyana Bandha. Energy concentrated on the chest area, the heart space. As I used to say, good for the thymus gland, good for our immune system, this wonderful Hatha Yoga pose. Good for the thyroid gland. One more deep, long breath. Exhale slowly next time and start rolling down vertebra by vertebra. Touch the floor, relax your back. Relax the lower back area and then you pull the knees towards your chest. Take a few breaths here. And my suggestion is, if you have the time now, a few minutes to relax with the legs towards the wall and something, cushions, pillows under your hips. Like supporting the hips and lifting the hips a little bit. This is not ideal. This is not too high. And you find a good angle for you and you rest for a few minutes like this. And I will be with you live the first week, January. Now we have a break, and it's going to be, I think, the 4th January. And I know, you know, I wish you all the best. All the best. Thank you for being here with me this year. Let's stay together. Un bacione moltissimo grandissimo a tutti!